welcoming today Dr. Anil Lamba. He's had two fabulous books, which are number one in the financial business, Financial Affairs of Common Man and Romancing with Balance Sheets. He has 2,000 plus companies where he has trained, 29 plus years in training people into finance, and he has a vision to train 1 billion people into financial intelligence. I take immense pleasure to welcome Dr. Anil Lamba on stage. I request Ajay ji to please escort him. It's a 2-minute session, we just crossed him, and we thought it would be fabulous for all of us to get an insight about what work he does. Thank you very much.
Good morning, everybody. Always a pleasure to address a JITO gathering. I just happened to be here, and therefore I met these wonderful people and I came in, so which is, please pardon my inappropriate attire today morning. My subject is finance, and normally if somebody asks me to speak for less than 8 hours, it is difficult to communicate what I want to say. So when they say speak for 5 minutes, I don't know what to tell you. But all of you are business people. Fortunately, about the subject of finance, you don't need to be told its importance. All of you already are aware. All I want to do is maybe share a statistic with you, that a study was conducted of all the sick businesses in the world, businesses that had failed. And the idea was to find out why do businesses fail. Now if I do some brainstorming with you, do you think the way technology is changing nowadays, do you think some old companies doing very well in the past, but who refuse to change with the times? New players came in, new technologies came in. Some companies might find themselves that they are in a position where the technology is out of date, and maybe they don't have the money to buy new technology, they become technologically obsolete. Do you think technological obsolescence can be responsible, can be one of the reasons for sickness in industry? Is it possible? There could be another category of businesses where technology is not a problem, ability to make is not a problem. They know how to make, but they don't know how to sell. Do you think marketing inefficiency can lead to sickness? Something that Prakash teaches very well, how to learn to become marketing experts. There could be one more category of business people where they know how to make, they know how to sell, but their misfortune is they have a militant and unreasonable trade union. For months, business shuts down due to strike. Do you think labor problems can lead to sickness? Now, the study that was conducted found that out of all the businesses that had failed, these three reasons together were not even responsible for 5% of business failures. And over 95% businesses in the world had failed due to one reason, and that is financial mismanagement. All I'm trying to drive home is the importance of the subject. Now what does it mean when somebody says, when a business fails due to financial mismanagement, what does it mean? You know, if somebody failed because technology became out of date, new players came in, foreign players came in, giants became your competitors, suddenly you found yourself lagging behind and didn't have the money to buy new technology, how can I blame you? If somebody goes sick because of labor problems, sympathies go out to him, how can you blame them? But when a business fails due to financial mismanagement, I think the entire blame lies on the entrepreneur's shoulders. Why did the business go sick? What does financial mismanagement mean? How many of you in this room are non-finance people? Not a single person can say I'm a non-finance person. Now this happens because Your definition of finance person is faulty. Let's say this was a corporate training program going on. You were all from one company. And the program was titled Finance for Non-Finance People. Who would be in the room? Marketing people will be there, production people will be there, HR people will be there, managing director himself may be there, who's a technocrat. And same question you ask them, how many of you are non-finance people? Every hand goes up. Because they've come to attend a program called Finance for Non-Finance. And then my answer is, not a single hand should have gone up when I asked you this question. So what do I mean by that? Folks, you must understand, you are under a wrong impression that finance happens in finance department. Production happens in production department. Marketing happens in marketing department. HR happens in HR department. Finance does not happen in finance department. Accountancy happens over there. So when those of you who said you are non-finance people, your hands went up, what you really meant was you are non-accounting people, but you are not non-finance people. So what's the distinction between the two? What does finance management mean? Who is a finance person? What is the job of a finance person? Is it the job of a finance person to track financial information, to collect financial data, to record that information, to collate that information, to prepare financial statements like profit loss accounts and balance sheets? Is that the job of the finance person? Answer is no, that is the job of the accounts person. So if all that is not finance management, then what is finance management? I will give you my definition and then I'll stop. I think finance management is the ability on the part of every individual in the organization to understand the financial implication of whatever you are doing. You might be aware of a financial jargon called bottom line. Bottom line refers to either profit or loss. I think the ability on the part of every individual in the organization to understand the impact on the organization's bottom line of every action of yours is what finance management is. And why should everybody understand how their actions impact the bottom line? So that as far as possible, every individual should do those things that have a positive impact on the bottom line and avoid doing things that have a negative impact. Folks, if this is what finance management is, then I think every individual in the organization whose actions have the power to affect the bottom line is a finance person. Now tell me, how many of your actions affect your company's bottom line? All hands will go. Then when people like you say, I'm a non-finance person, I kind of interpret that answer to be, you are saying, I don't care how my actions will affect my company's bottom line. And you are the owners. Can you imagine down the line? Not a single person can afford to say, finance management is not my job. Tell me, whose actions bring profit to the company? Is it the actions of the production person, the salesperson, the marketing person, or is it the actions of the accounts person? If there is one non-finance person in the company, it is the person who says, I'm a finance person. Because he's the only one who does nothing to generate profit. He's a very important person, I am one myself. But what I'm trying to tell you is, that person is not around when you are making profit. He is there to calculate the profit. After the rest of the organization has finished doing whatever they are doing, that department comes into the picture and tells you whether you have made a profit or loss. Should you call the actions that calculate profit as finance management, or should you call the actions that generate profit as finance management? How many non-finance people in this room? Lack of ability to understand this is responsible for 90 to 95% business failures in the world. Or I am saying, if more people had understood, finance management is my responsibility, and then taken the steps to arm themselves with that understanding, those companies that went sick need not have gone sick. So my humble appeal is, gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, the earlier you collect the ability, imbibe in you the ability to understand finance management. Can't leave it to only the account department. They are definitely finance people. But they are, by the time they come into the picture, the good or the damage is already done. They cannot undo what everybody has done. So when you decide to buy, suppose this hotel said, I want 1,000 podiums. The person who took a decision at what price, at what quantity, it has a financial implication. When the HR person decides what is the size of the manpower, what is the salary to be given, these are financial decisions. Production scheduling has a financial implication. Profit is nothing but the collection of financially intelligent actions taken by everybody in the organization. Otherwise, what happens? There are some people in the organization by whose actions the bottom line is becoming stronger. There are other people whose actions are eating into the bottom line. When those people whose actions are strengthening the bottom line, collectively speaking, when their actions are stronger than the others, net result is profit, vice versa, it is a loss. And when you make a profit, you start patting yourself on the back, I'm doing everything right. You don't even know how many people have eaten into that number. But can you now imagine the entire organization being financially literate? Where every individual taking only financially intelligent actions, can you imagine what an amazing organization would that be? Thank you so much for this opportunity. Really appreciate it. Thank you.